Imagine what life would have been like for those living with a psychotic mental illness 100 years ago. They were stigmatized and discriminated against by society. With minimal scientific knowledge about psychosis, people experiencing any symptoms would have been classified as insane or feeble-minded. Today, when it comes to mental illness, the two most commonly used diagnostic systems are the Diagnostic and Statistical Manual of Mental Disorders, or the DSM, and the International Classification of Diseases, or the ICD. Let's take a look at the diagnostic criteria for schizophrenia in the current DSM, the DSM-5. As a diagnosis, schizophrenia lives within a category of the DSM-5 called Schizophrenia Spectrum and Other Psychotic Disorders. For each specific mental illness, the DSM lists the criteria an individual must meet in order to be diagnosed with that illness. We are just going to cover the first criterion set, Criterion A, those relating to the symptoms of schizophrenia. Just to give you a sense of the diagnosis as a whole, though, the other criterion sets for schizophrenia relate to degree of dysfunction, duration, and exclusion of other possible causes of the presentation, such as substance use or other mental illnesses. In order to meet the criteria for this diagnosis, the symptoms must have been present for a 6-month period or longer, with at least 1 month of active symptoms. The 5 main symptom sets are delusions, hallucinations, disorganized speech, grossly disorganized or catatonic behavior, and negative symptoms. It isn't necessary for an individual to demonstrate all of these symptoms. To be diagnosed with schizophrenia, a person needs to show 2 or more symptoms. The symptoms of schizophrenia and other psychotic disorders are typically thought of and referred to as positive symptoms or negative symptoms. In this context, the word positive refers to the fact that the behaviours or experiences that make up these symptoms are happening too much. Negative symptoms, on the other hand, are behaviours that are essentially in deficit, behaviours that are not occurring as often as we would like. We're going to look at each of the symptoms in turn.